Let me introduce about myself. I have three children. My elder one is diagnosed with autism at age 3. That time the word autism was new to me. As every parent goes through, even I went through dark days and I was finally into depression. And the depression is due to the overworkload of the child. We get professional support. We get the support of everybody around us, but still the workload on the mother is more. At one stage I felt stagnated. I was not able to move beyond. I wanted a change in my routine and I wanted to come out of my depression. After so much of struggle, finally I wanted a support circle for myself, and finally I founded my group, Voice. Let me tell about Voice now. My elder one is on the spectrum, other two are fine. Voice is a parent group. It stands for Voice of Parents for Inclusion, Care and Empowerment of Children with Special Needs. The most important person in the child's life is the parent. Parent needs to be empowered. That's the main motto of this group. What we do in our group? First, we connect families with special needs. We support in every way possible. Every way. It may be physical support, emotional support, financial support, whatever support the family needs, we try to do. And we needed a platform to discuss our problems. We have loads of problems and we don't know whom to contact to discuss our problems. Initially, I thought, let me start this group and let us discuss our problem among ourselves. So we started to discuss our problems and we tried to find possible solutions. And the main thing we do is we advocate the rights of our children to the society. As yesterday Hari Parandaman sir mentioned, the society is very insensitive. The family needs the support. And for that, the society should be sensitive and society should be knowing the rights of the child. So, who else will do? Only the parents have to do. First, let the change come from the parent, and we parents have become the advocates for our children now. And we represent our issues to the government. What we do in our group? Most parents are educated, we have been working previously, now we are all full-time mothers for our children. Continuously we look after our children and finally we feel we need a break, we need a change. So what we do is we contribute our time, talent, any work based on our qualification and experience for our children. For example, a mother was a teacher, she teaches, she can teach other children. A mother was an advocate, she knows the legal issues. She can help other parents. And regular outings. Most of our families, we don't go for outings because our children will have many behavior issues and all. The society won't accept that. They won't understand our issues. So we feel isolated, and most of the time we don't go out. Within our families, we plan outings and we go out. Counseling sessions. Most of the time we will know, we will have mental health issues, we will have physical health issues, we will know our problem, but to go to the doctor, we won't have the time or the support from the family. So we thought, more than professional help, we can help out among ourselves. Senior parents can talk to junior parents, counseling sessions. Like many times we feel that we feel like we don't want any advice or solution, just a person to listen our problems. That will be fine for us. So among our group, senior parents talk with the newly diagnosed parents, and that will be more helpful. And celebrating success of us children. Because for a special child, every small thing is very much difficult, and the child has to put lot of hard work, and the parents behind them, they also put lot of efforts, lot of hard work, and it takes lot of time for a single thing to happen. And when we tell that to other parents, they not other parents, when we share this to people around us, they don't know the value of that. So what we do is we share it among ourselves, and every parent will feel that the success of one child is like success of everyone in the group. Yes. And in our group, we invite professionals related to the fields of our children, like medical professionals, advocates, activists, and who and all can help for our children, who and all can empower our parents. We invite people and they share their knowledge. And we have active volunteers. Most of the time, the parent won't have anybody to look after the child. Parents are the full-time caretakers for the child, and that's the reason parents don't come out of their house. And even for these parent meetings, without volunteers, we can't have these meetings. These volunteers, they look after our children outside the hall. They play with the children. We parents, we plan activities for them and tell the volunteers to look after our children. And these volunteers do this for our children. Only in this time, the parent attends the meeting. And in a voice group, the main motive is to empower parents. We empower parents. Once the parent is empowered, the child can be easily taken care of. That is the main motive of this group. And today we have many parents from our group to share their issues, to share their knowledge to the students. And I want to thank Deepak sir, because very rarely we find people like this. He works here and he has connected our group with the social work students here. And parents, we parents are like, we are the most important people in the child's life, but we are not considered anywhere. Our opinions, our experiences, our knowledge, maybe advocates or the medical people, they try to push their knowledge on us and most of the time convince us. But we parents are the real caretakers of the child, and we know the pain and we have more knowledge than anybody else about the child. Getting inputs from us would be the most appropriate thing, would be the very right thing, and I should thank Deepak sir for this opportunity for connecting voice with Lyra College. And Professor Francis sir, through Deepak sir I know him, and we have so many professors, but I don't find anybody who takes our issues, who takes the real problems of the society and works for them. I find Francis sir is one among the very rare people who are social workers, but still they don't do for us. They don't do much for us. Being a professor here and being a social worker, I should, my heartfelt thanks. I have no words to express my happiness, because we very rare people we find like this. They are really concerned about us and they get into our problems and try to help out of us. I should thank them from my heart, from the bottom of my heart, for helping us. Lyra College, finally. There are many colleges in Chennai. I don't find any college focusing on the real problems. They focus on education, most are business minded, but here in Lyra College, they provide space. All our meetings are conducted in Lyra College and they provide classrooms for us. We have all our meetings here. I should thank Lyra College for that.